But I was told not to read my blue material tonight, unless by popular demand people want to hear it. I'm going to take that as a no. Anyway, my first poetry book came out this June. It's called Astige of Balderdash from Trembling Pillow Press out of New Orleans. And somebody needs to get that last girl a record deal. Am I right? All right. So I'm going to read some poems from the book, or recite them, rather. Some of the more, some of the ones that may or may not have some social or redeeming social or moral value. All right, the first one's called Clothing for the Burial. Adorner, you sassy excuse for a her, floating through a dank Donna waft of elatedly disturbing calves. Though the season is springtime on the sly, double romanticized, a duo of narrow ever after Lee. Though she cannot deny her obligation to the couplet, her penchant for desserts and for sirs, werewolving through her hoped chest cockroach wonderfully, posing no place for a dove coat. The ragdoll lacerates its itch with a pickaxe in the darkest recesses of the human heart. Leave it to the decrepit to decipher their rot. Withdraw, ignore all, fanatically light bulb, regarding but the crawling of the listless between your my. We'd never absolutely for too long. Let me put on my bad girl dress and we'll do something absolutely wrong. It's about as sexy as it's getting tonight. Alright, the next piece is called Sending Flowers. Blithe undies, werewolven, starry blithe, so gendered in egoism ought to opt out of a slit, sowing white trashish and bluest misty tinnitus. She sighs werewolvenly as all blithes are undone one by one as the blouse. I wink until I'm familiar enough to name each part of his body. So now he ducks whenever he sees me coming with my detuned solfege and din of devour. Not even the dimmest of dearest is deserving of sensuality unraveled at the zenith of nearest. His rod emits Diana light, retunes to the ohm of thighs brushing baby fatly against. We dine on dementia in dour proportions. He says sour, I say knit me an elemento, please. After making love and light, we thaw out like snowmen made of shapes justly felt. Underage and twisty for a red rose's egos, laws laid down beside the gardener's corpse. What will it do once petunias have been chewed, bloom for bloom, and there is no more tweeting discreetly of a romance for love of a name so clouded in allowance? The rose emits her red color out of panic, nettled in timeless rovers for whom ravens forever flower at the mouth. This one's called Artichokes, and I honestly can't remember if the F word is in it, so sorry in advance. Artichokes, all right. Resignedly, I rain-sickly choke art. It single-handedly, irascibly dolloped atop its haphazardly, double-dipped in lousy, admittedly lolly, popped thine own cherries with thine own two tweets, mocking birds who could have never even seen that window coming. They were caught squint-eyed in the mirror whilst doling out reeds to the easterly, meddling, elided, brain-sickly, in dim lands of peace. We croak for content, ladling feel like fat scalped off the top. We emit hysterically, daycarely echoing, to sell our feel to the masses, strictly lackadaisically. We choke on the shrug, deferring daredevilishly, actively scrapping when you depress against me, evoking French parading with nothing to dote on. When petals scan the room, lipped and elatedly, we sop up the dew because hark the angels sung. And I wonder, where have you been all my holy? I saw you there, blind in both blues, tart in your eyes, the one you marry and clog daughterly in a Warren Beatty rape fantasy. I saw you there, standing with a look of everlasting, with five packs of smokes between you and your dream. You had me at everything's coming up roses, as the swan flings lower than lover, and the rose arts long as the swan haunts. A pile of myself I pick up and drop till the wretch be the body polite. In the days of yore, the days of my, the days of never being a lady tonight because all the gentlemen have seen my shut the fuck up, Lee. ODing awningly, just letting it all go in the nick of untimely, waiting impatiently for this night to do something other than be. I don't want to forget remembering you. I just want you to forget remembering me. Okay, I'm going to end it with a couple of shorter ones. So it's called Gift Horses. I am tonight without pride, because there's meerschaum over soft voices who would regift our belief in a love not to be with, a love not to wry about, a gift horse in the mouth, though the movie we're in. And the empty spinning stool next to me is all I've left of you, rum sweat. Ever since we teacupped each other's humbleness, peopled each other's nothingness, I have never known how not to wry about it. Though it was my pleasure, like a lock of Helen, there's schooling in the moaning bride, however, once, twice, three times, etc., etc. There are people in life, rest assured, tongue depressors. The proverbial, oh my, in the armful, terrible. A butter knife on the hem of the toast would be enough. Yet we contemplate the shine of the dull because it is skulls. A butter knife, non-serrated, would be enough. But the better knife is the one with which I'd refuse to brunch. I have with me a butter knife. I hope my hate will be enough. Thank you. I have books for sale. They normally go for $12, but I'll let them go for $10 tonight if you're interested. Thank you.